Hello and welcome to this Artisy Draft 3 tutorial. This video covers scripting in Artisy, with a focus on accessing object properties. In case you have never used the software, you might want to take a look at the First Steps tutorial series, before continuing with this video. In the First Step series, you will learn about global variables, update existing features or create entirely new ones, and see examples of basic scripting with Boolean variables. You can find a link to the series in the video description. Artisy Draft has its own easy-to-use expression language called Artisy Expresso. It gives you the means to shape your story flow with global variables, conditions, and instructions. Generally speaking, instructions are used to modify variable or property values, and conditions perform checks for these values and control the game flow by that. Conditions and instructions can be used in three different places: in the dedicated conditions or instruction nodes, inside node pins, where conditions always go into the input pin and instructions to the output pin, or within script fields of object templates. Conditions need to be a single statement that can be evaluated to a Boolean, like you can see on the screen here. You can write the entire statement or use a shortened form, as it is common in many programming languages. GameState.talkToNPC can be used instead of GameState.talkToNPC equals equals true, and !GameState.talkToNPC is the same as GameState.talkToNPC equals equals false. A whole number of relational operators can be used to compare values. With the help of logical operators, we can concatenate multiple comparisons into the condition statement. Instructions are one or more statements changing values. Please note that you have to end each statement with a semicolon if you use more than one statement. To change values, we are employing assignment operators. For example, setting a Boolean variable after talking to a certain NPC, or adding a reward sum to the player's credit balance. You can find the complete list of usable operators in the Artisy Help Center. The link is in the video description. Shaping and controlling the story or game flow with the help of global variables is already a powerful tool. But in addition to that, you can also access and modify object properties through scripting in Artisy. Let's take a closer look at that in the context of the small demo scene. We have two variables under the variable set game state, credits and skill points, both of type integer. On our player character, a template with two features is assigned, one of which is called skills. The flow consists of two dialogues. We will look at the condition dialogue first. The player character Lily is approached by the NPC Mr. Stavas. We want to have different dialogue options available to the player depending on which skills they possess. As we have seen earlier, the skills exist as properties in a template. Therefore, the way to check for them in a condition is a bit different from checking for a variable. As we can see in the comment of this condition node, we want to check if Lily has the conversation skill at least skill to 1. To handle object properties, there are built-in methods we can use. To access a property, we have to call getProp, as in getProperty. Then we have to specify the object to which the property belongs to. This we do by getObj, as in getObject. The object can be accessed by a technical name or by ID. This info can be found in the Objects General tab. The technical name of the player character is PC_Lily. Next comes the property name as a string. As we want to access template data, we need to write the technical name of the feature plus the property's technical name divided by a dot, here resulting in skills.conversation. Within strings, you do not have autocomplete, so make sure to write the names exactly as they are called in the feature. To finish the condition, all that's left to do is put in an operator and a value to check against. That might look daunting at first, but it's basically always the same structure if you want to check against an object property. Also, as soon as you start typing in a condition note or inside a pin, autocomplete will kick in, so you can select the needed method from the dropdown and just complete it by adding object and property names. If working with dialog fragments, we can shorten the expression with a substitute for the getObject part. Let's try it out in the next branching point of the conversation. If Lily does not have the conversation skill, she here gets another chance to increase her fee by showing knowledge from other skills. For this node, we want to check for the pilot skill. We start as before with getProperty. Instead of having to query for the object by calling getObject, we can use the convenient identifier speaker, which is an automatic reference to the current speaker object. Now we again add the property we want, in this case skills.pilot, and operator and value to check against. Of course, we can also use logical operators to expand these statements. Like in our last condition, where both the right skill and some spare skill points are necessary to display this option to the player. Now let's go to the instruction side of things. In this small dialog, our player character Lily is able to assign a skill point. When Lily interacts with the computer, she can choose from a number of skills. First is the pilot skill. We already have a statement in the output pin which removes the skill point by setting the skill point's variable value to its current value minus x, in this case minus 1. In the conditions earlier, we used getProp to access the value of a property. Now we want to change the value, so we have to call the setProp method, as in setProperty. Like before, we need to query the object to which the property belongs with getObject. This again we do with the technical name of the object, here pc_lily, followed by the property we want to modify, written as the technical names for feature plus property, divided by a dot. If we want to set the property value to an absolute number, we can do that pretty easily. Probably not the best way to set up a skill system, but for the sake of the example, let's just set the pilot skill value to 1 by typing the number. For the conversation skill, let's modify the value instead of setting it to an absolute number. We start out with our statement as before. SetProp, then get the object and the desired property. As we want to change the value of the property, we need to know its current value first. And this we do by querying it via getProp. Again, we need to say which object we do want to access and the name of the property in question. Then we specify how we want to change the property value. In our case, we want to add 1 to the current value. If this is the first time you are facing this kind of statement, it probably looks quite confusing. So let's take another look at both statements for conditions and instructions. First, we call a method, depending on what our goal is. In a condition, we want to see the current value of a property to be able to compare it with something, which we accomplish with getProp. In an instruction, we want to change the current value of a property. This we do with setProp. Next, we specify our target. Who or what do we want to see or change? This part is similar for conditions and instructions. Here we want to access skill information of our player character Lily. For a condition, the getProp expression is complete at this point. What we still need to do is add the comparison part to have a statement that will either give a true or false result. If at the current time Lily has 1 point assigned to the pilot skill, this condition will return true. The setProp expression needs a third part, the actual instruction of how the property we specified earlier is supposed to be modified. If we want to set a property to some specific value, we don't need to know what its current value is, as it will be overwritten anyways. This statement used in an instruction will set Lily's pilot skill to 1, regardless of how high it was before. If we want to modify the property value based on its current state, we need to access this value to see it first. Do you recognize this part of the statement? It is the exact same syntax for the getProperty expression as we used for the condition. Only instead of then comparing the value with something, we state how it needs to be modified. Here we want to add 1 to the current value of the selected property. If Lily had 1 point assigned currently, the new value of the pilot skill would be 2. Of course, if you are working with dialogue fragments and want to access properties of the speaker entity, you can use the speaker identifier in instructions as well. Last but not least, I want to go through the sample scene in the simulation view, so we can see how our instructions and conditions change the story flow. I start the simulation at the first dialogue node and drag out the second view pane with a property inspector view, so we can see live changes of variables and properties. This condition returns true, as we are checking for 1 or greater, and currently the variable value equals 1. Next, we can decide which course to take. I always wanted to know how to survive on faraway planets. If we confirm our selection, 2 things happen. First, we lose a skill point. The variable value is reduced by 1. And second, the survival property of the skills feature is increased by 1. Now we have arrived in the second dialogue. The first condition we encounter returns false, as we have not skilled conversation, so we cannot demand a higher fee right away. Here we have 2 options now. We can settle for the base fee, an option that is always accessible, or try to negotiate a little bit extra thanks to our survival skill. Now the credits variable gets updated. 4,000 credits, paid up front. Very nice. We have arrived at the end of this tutorial. You can now access and modify object properties via scripting, giving you another layer of depth for your story flow. Links to all documentation regarding scripting can be found in the video description. Take care and bye-bye!